Hello students, today we are going to see about belt and ropes. So the power can be transmitted by means of either flexible or non-flexible elements. The flexible elements, in the flexible element, the center distance can be changed conveniently based on the user, whereas for non-flexible element, it can't be changed. It may be a machine element. So the flexible type of machine element are belt, rope and chain, whereas for the non-flexible element, it will be having the clutches, couplings, the power screws and so on. So the flexible machine elements, which is used to transmit power over the long distance, the non-flexible elements is for short element. In belt and ropes, the power can be transmitted due to the friction between the pulleys, which is able to rotate either at the same speed or in different speeds. The amount of power transmitted along the following factors: the velocity of the belt, the tension under which the belt is placed on the pulleys, and then the arc of contact between the belt, and then based on the conditions that are used in the belt. So these are the factors that should be considered in the belt for transmitting the power. So it should be noted that the shaft should be properly in line to ensure the uniform tension across the belt section, and then the pulleys should not be too close together in order that the arc of contact on the smaller pulley may be large as possible. The pulley should not have so far apart to cause the belt weigh heavily on the shaft. A long belt to swing from side to side, causing the belt to run out of the pulleys, which in turn develop some crooked spots on the belt. The tight side of the belt should be at the bottom, and wherever the sag is present in the loose side, which will increase the arc of the contact of the pulleys. So these are the things that should be noted. So next, coming to the types of belt. So types of belt, so it can be categorized into many types. So classification is based on light drives, medium drives and heavy drives. So in light drives, they are used to transmit for small powers, for medium drives for medium power, and for heavy drives, they are used to transmit larger power. The speeds are given, and also the examples are also given. So the types of flat belt drives. So here the first one is the open belt drive. So the open belt drive is used with the shafts arranged parallel and rotating in the same direction. So in this, you will be having two pulleys, one is driver and another one is driven. One of the two connected pulleys in the belt is called the driver pulley or the driver. The other pulley, which is driven by the driver, is the driven pulley or the driven. It is also known as the follower. So in this, there will be having two sides, one is the slack and another one is the tight. So the driver pulley pulls the belt on the one side, that is the lower section, so it tends to pull over. When the driver rotates, the bottom side will be get pulled, so that is the tighter section, whereas the other will be somewhat looser, so that is the slack side. So this is the open belt drive. And next one is the cross belt drive. The cross belt drive, it is also known as twist belt drive, which is used with the shaft which is arranged parallel and is able to rotate in the opposite direction. So that is the cross belt drive, whereas the other two sides are the same. It will be having a driven and the driver, and it will be having a slack and the tight side. So the next one is the Compound belt drive. A compound belt drive is used when the power is transmitted from one shaft to the another by having number of pulleys. So where they are having larger center distance, there they will be using it in the compound belt drive. So this is the compound belt drive, and is the next one is the belt drive with single idler pulleys. So the idler pulley, this is also known as jockey pulley. So in which the tensioner is helps to provide the right level of tension on the belt and to ensure the correct operation. So wherever the center distance is very less, where you can't able to make the contact angle, there you will be using the idler pulley. So a belt drive with an idler pulley is used with the shaft which are arranged parallel. When the open belt drive cannot be used for a small angle of contact, so there you will be using the idler pulley. So open belt with many number of idler pulley, the belt with many idler pulley is used when it is desired to transmit the motion from one shaft to the several shaft. So that is the belt drive with many idler pulleys. The next one is quarter turn belt drive. The quarter turn belt drive is used with the shafts which are arranged in the right angles and the rotating in the different direction. So in this, the driver and the driven shaft will not get intersect, but they are at right angles to each other. So the driven pulley must be rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. The direction is reversed, the belt will run off the pulleys. And next one is the quarter turn belt with guided pulley. The quarter turn twist belt with the guide pulley is used with the shaft which are arranged right angles when the reversible motion is desired. So in this drive, the axis of the rotating, the axis of the driven and the driving shaft will get intersect when the power is produced which are at right angles to the each other. So the direction of rotation of the driven pulley is reversed, the belt will not run off the pulleys. So this is the quarter turn belt drive with the guided pulley. And the next one is the stepped or cone drive pulley. The stepped or cone drive pulley is used for changing the speed of the driven shaft while the driving shaft runs in the constant speed. So the stepped pulley are used for varying the speed of the driven machine. The speed of the driven machine can be varied accordingly by shifting the number of parts. So that is the cone pulley. And next one is the fast and the loose pulley drive. The fast and loose pulley drive is used when the driven or the machine shaft will be started or stopped whenever the desired get occurs without interfacing with the driving shaft. So this is the fast or the loose pulleys. So in any workshop or any machine shop, the driven from the single driving shaft, the shaft of the machine will be having two pulleys. One is the fast pulley and the other is the loose pulley. The fast pulley with the machine shaft is keyed with the machine shaft, whereas the loose pulley have bush on this hole. So this is the fast pulley and the loose pulley. The velocity ratio of the belt drive. So the velocity ratio is defined as the ratio between the velocity of the driver and the driven. So driven is also known as follower. So the velocity ratio is nothing but N2 by N1 is equal to D1 by D2. So the ratio of velocity of two pulleys. So D1 and D2 are the diameter of the driver and the follower, and the N1 and N2 are the speeds. So by considering the thickness, N2 by N1 is equal to D1 plus T divided by D2 plus T. So this is the velocity ratio of the belt drive. So for us, the velocity of the compound belt drive, so speed of the compound belt drive, we already know what is compound belt drive. In order to transmit power through more number of pulleys, So that is the compound drive. So more number of pulleys means you will be having the different values of D1. So D1, D2, D3, D4 are the corresponding pulley diameter. N1, N2, N3 and N4 are the corresponding speed of the pulley in RPM. So velocity ratio of compound belt drive, that is nothing but speed of the last driven divided by speed of the first driver, which is equal to product of diameters of all drivers divided by product of diameters of all driven. So there they are given as a formula by considering 6 number of pulleys and 6 number of speed. So slip of the belt. Slip is defined as the relative motion between the belt and the pulley due to insufficient friction between the bolt and the pulley. The difference between the linear speed of the pulley rim and belt is the measure of the slip. The reason for the slip to occur is that there is a tendency of belt to carry with it on the underside between the pulley and the belt. So therefore the friction gap between the pulley and the belt occurs, which is a insufficient one. So the presence of slip reduces the velocity ratio of the drive. So here they have given the value of the S1 and S2 are in terms of percentage. So slip between the driver of the belt, slip between the belt and the follower. So the velocity ratio is D1 divided by D2 into 1 minus S divided by 100. So the value of S will be the percentage of 2. Slip by considering the thickness means N2 by N1 is equal to D1 plus T divided by D2 plus T into 1 minus S divided by 100. So that is the velocity ratio of, slip of the belt. And next is the creep. The creep may be defined as the relative motion between the belt and the pulley surface due to unequal stretching of the two sides of the drive. The effect of the creep is to reduce the speed of the driven pulley and consequently the power transmitted. So N2 by N1 is equal to D1 divided by D2 into E plus square root of sigma 2 divided by E1 plus square root of sigma 1. So we know N2, N1, D1, D2. E is the Young's modulus of the material of the belt. Sigma 1 and sigma 2 are the stresses on the belt on the tight and the slack side. So this is the creep of the belt. This is the length of the open belt drive. So the length of open belt drive can be found by means of two methods. One is the mathematical method and another one is the practical method. So in practical method means we should be able to take a string and you should be able to wound it on the pulleys and you can able to measure. So that is a practical manner. So the next one is the mathematical manner that we are going to see it here. That is the formula wise. So here the R1 and R2 are the larger pulley and the smaller pulley radius. The X is the distance between the center and L is the total length of the belt. So one value they have not given is that is the value of alpha. So the alpha is the angle subtended between the straight portion of the belt. So normally we will be taking at 2 alpha. So the half of the value is as the alpha. Alpha is the angle subtended between the straight portion of the belt. So here L is equal to pi into R1 plus R2 plus 2x plus R1 minus R2 the whole square divided by x. So in terms of radii. So for if you take in terms of diameter pi by 2 D1 plus D2 plus 2x plus D1 minus D2 by 4x the whole square. So this is the length of the open belt drive. So next one is the cross belt drive. So here also the same notation, only the formula get differs. L is equal to pi into R1 plus R2 plus 2x R1 plus R2 the whole square divided by x in terms of diameter pi by 2
d1 plus d2 plus 2x plus d1 plus d2 the whole square divided by 4x. So this is the length of the cross belt drive. So in order to determine the angle of contact, here sin pi is equal to sin alpha is equal to r1 minus r2 divided by x. Via x we already know that is the center distance value. R1 and r2 are the radius of larger pulley and the smaller pulley. So theta value is the angle of contact or angle of lap. When two pulleys of different diameters are in contact by means of open belt, then the angle of contact theta at the smaller pulley must be taken into the consideration. So here they are given two values. One is for the open belt drive. So for the cross belt drive, theta is equal to 180 plus 2 alpha into pi by 180 radian. Sin alpha is equal to r1 plus r2 divided by x. So this is the determination of the angle of contact. So next, the power transmitted in the belt. So here the T1 and T2 are the tension on the tight and the slack side. R1 and R2 are the radii of the driver and the follower. P is the power transmitted by the belt. You will be having fewer values required, D1, D2 and N1 and N2, that we already known. So here the work done per second in terms of Newton meter per second. So that is what? Newton meter per second is what? So work done in terms of what? T1 minus T2 into V, that is nothing but the velocity of the belt. So the power transmitted is equal to T1 minus T2 into V watt. So the little consideration will show that torque exerted by the driving pulley is T1 minus T2 into R1. For driven pulley, T1 minus T2 is R2. With this we can able to calculate the efficiency of the belt drive. The efficiency of the belt drive is output power to the input power. So these are the main formulas. The torque exerted by the driven pulley is T1 minus T2 into R. Torque exerted by the driven pulley, that is the follower, T1 minus T2 into R2. The power transmitted is T1 minus T2 into V. So that is the velocity. Next one is the ratio of the driving tension of the flat belt drive. So the belt drive primarily operates based on the friction. So the friction is between the belt and the pulley, which will be the major responsible for transmitting the power from one pulley to the another. So due to the presence of the friction between the belt and the pulley, the tension gate occurs on both the pulleys as well as the belt. So that is not equal. So normally there will be two tension, so T1 and T2, one is on the slack and another one is on the tight. So T1 will be for the tight side and T2 is for the slack side. So the tension on the tight side will be always higher than the slack, so T1 is always greater than T2. So the slack will be likely slack in section, that we have seen in the first diagram. This is due to the self weight of the belt. So that there is a slight slack in the belt. So here T1 and T2 are the tension on the tight side and the slack side. Theta is the angle of contact in radian. So the tension ratio T1 by D2 is equal to e power mu theta. So mu is the coefficient of friction and theta is the angle of contact in radian. So there they are given it in a simplified manner. 2.3 log T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. The above expression gives the relation between the tight side and the slack side tension in terms of coefficient of friction and the angle of contact. And the next one is the centrifugal section. So here the belt will be running in a continuous manner. So therefore the centrifugal forces get occurs, whose effect is to increase the tension on both tight as well as the slack side. The tension caused by the centrifugal force is the centrifugal tension. So at lower speed of the belt, that is less than 10 meter per second, when the velocity is less than 10 meter per second, the velocity of the tension is very less, so it is almost negligible amount. Whereas for high speed belt more than 10 meter per second, the effect is considerable and thus it should be taken into account. So here the mass of the weight per unit length M and V is the velocity of the belt and R is the radius of the pulley. Here one more new term, TC will be there. TC is the centrifugal tension acting tangentially at point P and Q. So this is, so TC is equal to M into V square, where M is the mass of the belt per unit length and V is the linear velocity. So at the bottom they have given the power transmitted. Power transmitted is equal to T1 minus T2 into V, which is same formula of the previous one. So the ratio of driving to the driven may be taken it as the 2.3 log T1 minus TC divided by TT2 minus TC, where T1 is the maximum and the total tension of the belt, that is the sum of both the values of T1 and T2, that is the centrifugal tension on the belt by considering the stress induced in the belt. So a little consideration will show the maximum tension in the belt is equal to the total tension on the tight side of the belt. So T1 is equal to, that is T1. So the maximum stress in it is, maximum tension is the maximum stress into the cross section of the belt, where B will be the thickness, width and T is the thickness of the belt. So the maximum tension T is equal to sigma into B into T. So when the centrifugal tension is neglected, so T is equal to T1, and when the centrifugal tension is considered, T is equal to T1 plus TC, that is the centrifugal tension. So this is the maximum tension in the belt. And next one is the condition of transmitting the power. So here P is the power. P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V, where V is the velocity of the belt. So the total tension occurs, T is equal to 3 times the TC. So T1 is equal to T minus TC, where TC is the centrifugal tension and T is the maximum tension. We know that. So these are the few formulas. So the maximum power is, the maximum power V is equal to T divided by square root of 3 into M. So that is the maximum velocity. Next, coming to the initial tension in the belt. So the tension of the belt, when the belt is fixed to a pair of a pulley, when the system is stationary. So this is termed as the initial tension belt. So it will be saying it is as the T0. So T0 is equal to T1 plus T2 divided by 2 by neglecting the centrifugal tension, whereas by considering the centrifugal tension, T0 is equal to T1 plus T2 plus 2TC divided by 2. So that is the initial tension. So next we are coming to the V belt drive. So here the cross section is also the given. So when the belt is in terms of trapezoidal in section and it is designed to in the form of V-shaped groove, so that is the V belt. It is an alternative way of increasing the ratio of tension The V belt is particularly suitable for the shafts which are having very short distance apart. The V belt is made up of fabric and cords which are molded in rubber. So that is the V shaped belt. So it will be having three layers. One is the rubber and another one is cord, and the outer is covered by means of fabric and the rubber. So there are few advantages and disadvantages of the flat belt drive. The power transmitted is more due to the wedging in action of the groove pulleys. The V belt is more compact and it is capable of shocking absorption. It will be having high velocity ratio to the maximum of 10. The strength of the material is more efficiently used. Multiple V belts are used for enabling and transmitting more power. So it will be having large lives and it can be easily installed. So these are the few advantages of the V belt drive. There are also having few disadvantages. It cannot be used for larger center distance. So it is not durable as that of the flat. Since the V belt is subjected to certain amount of creep, it is not suitable for constant speed applications and it can't able to synchronize with the other machines or any other timing device. So the centrifugal tension prevents the use of V belt as the speed is below 5 meter per second and above 50 meter per second. So these are the few disadvantages of the V shape belt drive. So the ratio of driving tension of V belt T1 by D2 is equal to e power mu cosec beta. So T1 and T2 are the tension in tight and slack side. 2 beta is the angle of the groove and mu is the coefficient of friction. So the number of belt can be calculated by means of total power transmitted divided by power transmitted per belt. The value of groove angle 2 beta for flat belt drive, it is 180 degree. So the tension ratio is T1 by D2 is equal to e power mu theta. So this is the ratio of the driving tension. And next one, coming to the rope drive. The rope drive is widely used in large power and can be able to transmit it continuously from one pulley to the another over considerable distance. One of the main advantage of rope drive is the number of separate drives may be taken from one driving pulley. So the materials used in rope drive are cotton, hemp, and the cross section will be of square in section. So there are two types of ropes, fiber ropes and wire ropes. They do having some advantages that are described. The ratio of the driving tension is T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu cosec beta, whereas the mu, theta and beta are same as that of the V belt. So okay, so this just all the flat belt and the rope. So here they have given the formula in the very simplified manner. They have given the velocity of the belt drive by considering the thickness, without considering the thickness, by considering the slip, by considering the creep effect. They have given the velocity ratio, the length of open belt, cross belt drive, and then the angle of contact, and then the tension ratio, power transmitted. So these are the formulas you should be able to know before going to the problems. So the power transmitted by the belt, the centrifugal tension, the maximum tension in the belt, the condition of power for maximum transmission in the belt, and then the initial tension, the tension ratio, these are the all we have discussed in this video. So thank you.